Good morning, world. We are at Warsaw Airport and we are departing for Budapest in a short hour and a half. It's a nice morning. It's like 10 degrees and sunny, and our flight is about an hour and a half. It's pretty short, and companion for today is mother. We're going together and we're very, very excited for this journey. So join us. Hi, mom.
Hi.
How are you feeling?
Good.
Why is it not focusing? Well, we made it through security and we have a lot of time, so we're going to our gate now. Here we go. Just landed in Budapest, and that was such a quick flight from Warsaw. It actually only took 1 hour, which is surprising. And the plane we flew was Wizz Air, and I thought it was gonna be crappy, but it was actually really good. So I'm so far pretty impressed. Now we're going to take the bus, the shuttle bus into town. Reporting to you live from Budapest downtown center area. Mom and I just got here and we are going to enjoy a little snack on this park bench with this view. So far, it's a nice warm day. It was supposed to rain, but it looks like the sun is peeking through, so we're happy. And we are just having some salami and cheese. How European. And behind us is this nice bush that smells like honey. It smells like spring. Mom's already digging in to her croissant.
It is not croissant.
Oh, what is it? Rogalik. Rogalik.
Bun.
Bun?
Salt. More salt.
So I'm trying this salted caramel iced coffee. I'm very interested. Let's see what it tastes like. That's actually really nice. It's like, it's subtle, but it's like caramelly. It's really nice. 8 out of 10. We just went down to the metro line for fun. And I thought it was interesting how old the metro is. It's very unique and characteristic. It's got a nice yellow color, quite old. And also the metro is made of this shiny brick walls. So it's all pretty nice, nicely preserved and well kept, and like even the doors to the metro are very, very beautiful. So yeah, pretty unique. So Gerbode, it's a really beautiful cafe in Old Town. Just walking around spontaneously, we don't actually have a plan. So far I can say that Old Town is really open. It's like a big space. It kind of reminds me of Vienna, which is nice because it doesn't really feel as crowded. Vasi Utsa is the main promenade, like walking space for tourists. It's got a lot of shops and things to see. So we see the other side of Budapest from on the other side of the Danube River, and we are probably gonna go there tomorrow, and then today we're gonna stay on this side because I'm sure, as you all believe, it's a lot of walking. But right now we're just gonna go to a viewpoint on that side over there. So far the weather is kind of perfect. It's like really warm wind, but it's still about like 17 degrees, so it's really nice. Alright, so now we are at this viewpoint. We're walking up the beautiful stairs. So we came from about there, we crossed the bridge. So far it's really beautiful. There's lots of lavender growing. It smells very beautiful. Mom, do you like it?
Yes.
I had to take off my jacket because it's so hot. Of course, we're climbing. We're getting some elevation, so kind of like a hike.
We made it to the first stop. It's like this Roman.
So here is the view from where we just walked. I just wanted to videotape the stairs because they're just beautiful.
So we just got back to the main old town area and now we're just spontaneously walking. And we found this nice boulevard that we're just going to walk down. I really, really appreciate how, like, in Budapest here, they really incorporate trees into like all these spaces, so it like feels more natural. And right now in April, like, everything's super green, so it's really a stunning time. So we're just walking around looking for a place to grab a bite. There is this cafe, Anna Cafe. It's pretty popular here.
Maybe tomorrow we'll head there for some coffee, but right now we're looking for some traditional goulash, and then after that I'll probably get something sweet. I was looking at chimney cakes, or this guy was selling some gelato for an affordable price, so I might go get some ice cream because it's still pretty warm. I also checked the humidity and it's 80% today, which is insane. That's why I'm sweating.
All right, so we made a pit stop at this Hungarian bistro called Paul's, and it's obviously one of those classic cafes right off of the main promenade, and we're trying the beef goulash soup. So this is what it looks like. It's really hearty. Beef, potatoes, carrots, and apparently lots of spices. And then best enjoyed with some bread. Bon appetit, mother.
Bon appetit, daughter.
Well, my mom has been making this since I was a kid, but like a Polish style, so I'm curious to see if it'll be similar. But I'm assuming so. Oh, that's delicious. Wow, highly recommend. The broth is very flavorful. I feel like I can feel like some spice. Very good. So we're gonna enjoy this. I like know this taste from when I was a kid, so yeah, I think goulash is just really delicious in general. So if you're in Budapest, definitely give it a try.
Yum.
The rain caught us, unfortunately. So we're waiting for this cloud to pass, but it's raining pretty hard. We're just on our way to our Airbnb. Hey fam, so it's been a couple hours since we last chatted. So welcome to our Airbnb for the next two nights. Mom and I decided to take a little break here just because, you know, we've been up since an ungodly hour, 5 a.m. So we had to take a 20-minute nap and just like take an hour to relax. So I just wanted to quickly do a little tour of our Airbnb. So it's really just a cute little space. Very fancy chandelier. But like, yeah, it has everything we need. Small kitchenette, little dining space. There's a big bathroom in the back, and we are in like one of the old buildings. And here's the bathroom. It's a nice size again. But yeah, we're about to head out now again for a little walk.
We're not directly in the center, we're a little bit east. Yeah, like in the 5th district, I don't know. But yeah, we're gonna take a walk around our area just to finish the night off because it is still 6 p.m. So we wanna get some more walking and sightseeing in. And then we're gonna get home and we're gonna go to sleep because we're so tired and we're planning to get up early again tomorrow.
So I just dressed up a little bit warmer because it is 15 degrees now. So we gotta stay warm, scarf, and let's go.
So this is actually the Airbnb building we're staying at. So it's really like outdated, but it's like a courtyard. I think it's pretty cool though. It's really authentic, so that's nice. We just stumbled upon New York Cafe. And it is truly the most beautiful cafe I've seen in my life. Wow. There's too long of a line to like dine in, but it's stunning. We're just strolling around. It's starting to get dark slowly. But it's a vibe.
girls trip.
Flower fields are insane right now. Especially this time of year, everything's like full bloom. It is amazing. There's a gorgeous mix of different flowers here. Mom is in heaven.
And we're back, but I'm actually signing off for tonight, so we're finally home and now we're going to relax and head to sleep. It is Monday night, so we did a whole day of exploring today, and yeah, I think we're done. So we will see you in the morning. We are just probably going to make some tea and then go to bed. But yeah, thanks for joining today, and we'll see you in the morning. Good morning.
We're up and at 'em.
Good morning, Kaya.
Mom and I were on that white bridge yesterday, and then we're gonna come back on the middle bridge, and we're just gonna explore this area today. We made it to this boardwalk area along the Danube River. So Mom and I had a pretty good sleep. We actually slept in till about, we first had an alarm at 8, but we slept until like 9 after not sleeping that long yesterday. And we're feeling really good today. Like, our bodies really needed that, so we're ready to explore all day. And yeah, I'm very excited to see more beautiful views of this city, and I think the sun's gonna come out soon. So that's also a treat so far. It's very nice. This is so pretty. I honestly don't feel like humans made this. It's just so precise and detailed. Like, it's impressive. So pretty. We have made it to the Fisherman's Bastion, which is where we're going next. This is the view from the bottom of the bastion. We're gonna head up there. Y'all, this view is unbelievable. The higher you go, obviously the better. There's like this little square at the top here. So many little cafes. It's so pretty. Look at that detail on the roof. Think about how much work that took. That's crazy. But it's colorful, which always adds some vibrance to the atmosphere, the environment. Here's a little close-up of the roof, just so you guys can see the detail and the color. It's beautiful. There's Mom. We're just walking around, having a grand time. Of course, taking a few photos. Just a few, you know, just like 2 or 3 thousand. We are now in front of Buda Castle, and I just wanted to show you these beautiful fences. This area is extremely green. It's very nice. It just shows that the climate is much milder here, and I think it's warmer faster. I mean, we are decently south, so makes sense. Back on the tram, heading to the other side of the city again, closer to the parliament. And then we're gonna probably grab some food and then head over to home, because we need to like grab our swimsuits because we are gonna go to the bath. We are now in front of the Hungarian parliament building. Kind of like a different view, but it's really spectacular. I feel like there's a lot of different artistic styles in this building, but it really, really is worth the visit. The sun is out, as you can tell, and it's a beautiful day. Yeah, I'm actually really impressed by the architecture here. Like, everything is really well preserved, and yeah, it's stunning.
je te prenne, que je te traîne, que je te joue sur mon piano. Underground we go to the trams. I think, at least to the trams. We were indeed correct. This is a tram line. It's kind of like the metro underground. But you have to like take the escalator a lot. Like, it just takes forever to get down here. It's really deep in the ground, so that's interesting. Alright, so we made it to the entrance of the baths. We got these little wristbands and we're about to head into the pools. So green. There's a hot air balloon back there too. It's very nice. We made it to the outdoor thermal pools and it's so stunning. Woo! We are so excited to spend the next couple hours here. It's exactly what I imagined it to be, even better. One thermal bath done. We're just cooling off in the sun for a little bit, but we're still wearing towels because it's not that warm yet. And then we're gonna go into another pool and just kind of make the rounds, yeah. Because we can be here for unlimited time and they're open till 8, so that's really nice. And here are the other pools that we're probably gonna hang here for the rest. So we're all done, I just changed and we're about to head to our dinner spot because we're pretty hungry. You know how the water like really dries you out and makes you hungry, so off we go. Nice little walk through the park to dinner. We're going to this Hungarian restaurant. This dog is so cute. This is our dinner spot. It's called Paprika Vendeglo. And apparently it's supposed to be super authentic Hungarian, so let's find out together. The inside is very traditional Hungarian. Very nice. We're waiting for our food. It's really cool. Dinner is served. Mama, what did you say?
Oh wow.
Oh wow.
Zeberka, ziemniaczki i modra kapusta.
I can't get over how amazing this looks. I got a veal dish with, I think, potatoes, but it also looks so tasty. This is some real traditional Hungarian food. Let's dig in. So we're all post-dinner. It was amazing, delicious. If you're ever in Budapest, we really highly recommend Paprika Vendeglo. It has amazing, amazing food, service. The environment is top-notch, so feel free to go there. It's a tried and true dinner spot. Just make sure you get a reservation because it is really busy in there. So now we're standing on this square, which is right outside of the park. And here we have Roman columns. And then another building like that. So it's a pretty popular square. It's really nice. There's this really, really nice boulevard of trees right there. And we're just about to head into the metro underground and head home. So we just got home and we're actually gonna wind down and head to sleep because we have to be up at 4 in the morning to catch our flight. So that's it for today. Thanks for tuning in. It was an amazing day. We had so much fun. I just wanted to show you the cutest postcards that I bought as a memory. This one I'll probably frame. And this one I'll send back home. Good night. On the way to the airport. It's currently 4 in the morning, but we got up. I'm not gonna lie, I'm kind of tired, but I did sleep a couple hours, so that's at least good. This airport is quite nice. Eating a croissant at 5 a.m. and walking to our gate.